are listening to Radio Harold Hill. Broadcasting from the heart of London to your heart. Radio Harold Hill.
All of your dreams, all of your ideas, need one thing if you want them to come true. Inspiration. Join Sheun David-Onamusi on Inspiration Road 10 a.m. every Saturday on Radio Harold Hill. Inspiration Road, a show dedicated to keeping you company on your road to success.
Good morning. Welcome to Inspiration Road with Sheun David-Onamusi. Thank you so much for joining me on today's show. On today's show, if you are actually just joining Inspiration Road or just catching up on Inspiration Road for the first time, Inspiration Road is dedicated to keeping you company on your journey to success. And on Inspiration Road, I bring guests on the show. We'll talk about their personal experiences. Guests will actually share where they are and some of the key attributes of success. On Inspiration Road, I look at seven areas of fulfillment because my goal is not just to encourage you to be successful financially, but to be successful in every area of your life. And on today's show, we're going to be talking about something critical to success, something very, very important to success. But before we go on a quick music break, let me set it up for you. Let me set a stage for you to understand what we're going to be talking about today. Now, growing up in Nigeria, I grew up in Nigeria. Forget the accent. It might not show, but I grew up in Nigeria, okay? All right, so growing up in Nigeria, I would remember haggling for a bus to get on the local mass transit. And it perhaps was one of the most chaotic and sometimes traumatic experience you can ever have, you know, because you have to push your way through to get on the bus. Now, when I get on the bus after struggling and sometimes, and shamefully, I'm ashamed to say this, sometimes even pushing off an old lady to get on the bus, you know, or sometimes it might be a youngie like myself. But haggling and pushing through and getting on the bus, thinking, yes, it's peacetime, I can enjoy my journey to where I'm going. Then there comes a salesperson, typically an aged man, you know, an adult man. It will come and it will have this carrier bag. And in his carrier bag, sometimes he will have a megaphone. And in his carrier bag, he will have powder-like substances, and he will start to share that this powder-like substance can cure all disease, from diabetes to cancer to headaches to diarrhea. He would say this powder-like substance can cure all things. Now, as a young kid, I used to think in my head, how is that possible? I used to try and rationalize it, and he says, this medicine cures all things. Now, retrospectively thinking, I know that's not true because it's not tested. The powder is not tested. And I hope a lot of people didn't die from it, but that's another story for another day. But on today's show, we're going to be talking about something that I am convinced cures most, if not all, of our illness on our pursuit for happiness. You know, we all suffer from something or another, but this topic, this talk today, I guarantee you, cures all, if most, if not all, illness that you will suffer on your journey to success. So, we'll be right back. This is Mary Mary and Kirk Franklin saying thank you.
When I look back over my life, thank you. And all the times you brought me through, thank you. I just want to say, Father, thank you.
When I was lonely and needed someone to hold me, you were beside me when my nights got cold and lonely. Oh, you never let me down when
no one's to be found by.
Always count on you to see me through. I'm telling you that you are the reason I'm alive.
Now my life, it has new meaning.
When I think about your grace,
when my nights got cold and lonely.
Welcome back to Inspiration Road with Sheun David-Onamusi. That was Mary Mary with Kirk Franklin saying thank you. And yes, you might have guessed right. Today's show will be talking about the spirit of thanksgiving and gratitude. I know for all my American listeners, I've had a couple of messages from people in America saying, you know what, I listen to you on a regular basis. Thank you so much for tuning in. And I know you are out there celebrating Thanksgiving. And even here in London, we are, that spirit of Thanksgiving is catching on for some people. I'm sure you've been out on Black Friday getting some gift items and the rest of it. So it's in the air. So why not talk about it? Before we went on that music break, I shared the story of growing up in Nigeria and how I would get on the bus and a salesman would come and say there was a medicine that cures all illness. And even though his powder-like substance was not verified to do that, I am proposing today that this topic, gratitude, having the spirit of thanksgiving, will cure most of your illness, if not all of your illness. Researchers, there were a couple of researchers a number of years ago, they gathered a number of students and they put them in different groups. The first group, they told them to write a list of things that they are happy and thankful about. Another group, they said, write the things that you're angry about. And the last group, they said, write a list of 20 things that you are, random things, such as the color of my shoes, the color of my bed, the size of my bed, the size of my car, just random things. But without putting an element of thanksgiving towards it and just say, just write random things. Now, after the research was done, as your guess is probably right, the happiest of those of those groups of people was actually those who penned down what they were happy and thankful about. Now, these researchers also found out that some of the illness, in terms of physical illness, body-wise, that we suffer from, actually comes from bad hormones and really terrible feelings that come from the hormones created, which then makes our health depreciate. So when it comes to Thanksgiving, it's not just about celebrating a period of some historical truths or just a time to get good sales. It's not just a time to eat turkey and catch jokes about your family. No, no, no. It's actually beyond that. It is about having a gratitude, a grateful mindset. Now, on your journey to success, as I mentioned earlier on, you will suffer a lot of illness. And I'm not talking about just physical illness. That's not what I mean. Sometimes depression, even though that's been diagnosed as a health situation for some people now. But unhappiness and sometimes disappointments and different things that you will encounter from being let down, from failure to all sorts of things that you'll suffer. And that's what I term illness on your journey to success. Now, you will suffer all these things, but if you are resolute about being grateful, because we don't find that anymore these days. If you look at your friends list and you look at even some of the conversations that go on between friends these days, people rarely tell their friends, you know what? I'm grateful that I have you as a friend. I'm actually happy that I have you as a friend. I'm grateful that I can come to you and we can chill. You know, not a lot of people have that opportunity to have friends that they can go and chill with and just play PS4, or, you know, just watch a series with or whatever it is. You know, not a lot of people have that. Unfortunately, we have lost the spirit of gratitude. It appears that we are like the second group that those researchers put together. We have a lot of things that we are angry about. You know, we're angry about this. The world is not doing this. Syria is doing that. Libya is doing that. The terrorists are doing that. And all these things are really, really important things that we have to deal with. So I'm not belittling the threats and some of the ills that's going on. The lack of jobs for young people across the world. Governments failing different people. Getting tougher to get on the property ladder in the UK for young people, in America, all sorts of issues. It's global. As long as we live, there will be problem. So why should we take all those negative energy and make it a lifestyle for ourselves? Why not choose to think the opposite direction and think of things you're thankful of? So yesterday I was driving back from a town way after Oxford because I've been there for 3 days of training, sales training to be precise. And on my way back, I drove past the area I grew up in London. And as I was driving back, this thing just came over me. I just remembered those days that I could not afford a car. I remember those days that I could not afford a lot of things that I take for granted now. Even days when I didn't have the show, you know, I didn't have people listen to me or people look up to me for advice or counsel. I remember those days that I was depressed. You know, I remember those days that things were just not going well for me, you know, and I just was thankful. And that's the same thing we have to do. Go back to where you're coming from and think about things that you're grateful for. I read a blog not too long ago, and this gentleman, when he was talking about this gratitude and grateful and Thanksgiving, he actually started thanking God for random things. You know, I had another person who didn't believe in God. He was just writing down, I'm thankful, I'm grateful. So it's not about, you know, the religious element, you know. So if you're not religious or you don't believe in a God, that's fine. You can still be grateful. You can still be grateful and show that gratitude and be thankful, because life is not what you want it to be, but surely it's not what it used to be. You know, there's always progress. So this, the first gentleman was thanking God. He was writing things like, I'm thankful for the online community. I'm thankful for the people that I come across on Facebook. I'm thankful for the people I come across on Twitter, because they make my life interesting. Because then I go on their page and I see something they write on their wall that makes me laugh. And laughter does good like medicine. You know, laughter is great. So I am thankful that I can go on Facebook. You know, in our generation, we probably are the most privileged generation that has ever lived. In the sense that in our hands, we have the ability to broadcast our thoughts to millions of people. And those thoughts of ours can change people's lives. We can share our products and services to many people without paying the huge TV advertising. That's something to be thankful about if you're in business. So think about those elements while you're bogged down thinking about, okay, how am I going to make it? And yes, you have to strategize and start thinking of how to move your dreams and your ideas from just an idea level to fruition. Yes, you must strategize. You must think. You must be, I believe that you must be pragmatic, you know, on certain things. What's not working, identify it and identify those things that are not right. That's fine. But you cannot live your life focusing on what's not working. You must focus on what's working. There's an 80-20 rule that I teach and a lot of speakers like myself teach. And that it is that 80% of your result will come from 20% of your activities. So in essence, 80% or 80% of your profit, for example, will come from 20% of your customers. So in the same way, in terms of personal development, 80% of your productivity will come from 20% of your focus. So your 20% of focus, for example, is let's say your strength. So the more you focus on your strength, the more productive you become. Because as human beings, we can fall into that way of thinking of negative thoughts and thinking of what's not working, what I'm not good at. And on last week's show, we had Catherine Labinjo on the show, and we were talking about partnership. And she said something very critical. And she said that if you are going to go into partnership, don't focus on what you don't have. Focus on what you have and then go into partnership with somebody that has something that you don't have. Rather than focusing on, no, I'm not good with finances, why not focus on the fact that you are great at people skills? You're a fantastic communicator. Focus on that. Don't focus on the fact that you are not financially savvy. Look for somebody else that fills that gap. All right, so I'll be right back. The couple of things I wanted to mention that are critical, how to develop this spirit of thanksgiving and actually developing the ability to be grateful in that sense. What's that one thing you should start doing now after you get off the show? What's that one thing that you should start doing that will get you into that mood and spirit of thanksgiving? Well, this is Sam Smith saying stay with me. So don't go away. Stay with me, okay? Be right back.
Guess it's true I'm not good at a one-night stand, but I still need love 'cause I'm just a man. nights never seem to go to plan. I don't want you to leave, will you hold my hand? Oh, won't you stay with me? 'Cause you're all I need. This ain't love, it's clear to see. But darling, stay with me. Why am I so emotional? No, it's not a good look and some self-control. Deep down I know this never works, but you can lay with me so it doesn't hurt. Oh, won't you stay with me? 'Cause you're all I need. This ain't love, it's clear to see. But darling, stay.
Welcome back to Inspiration Road with Sheun David-Onamusi. Thank you for staying with me. If you are just joining in, this is Inspiration Road with Sheun David-Onamusi. And on Inspiration Road, the focus is keeping you journey on your, keeping you company on your journey to success. Today's show, we've been talking about that one medicine that is important to healthy living in terms of it cures most, if not all, illness in that sense. That's the preposition today. And what's that medicine? Is gratitude, is having the spirit of thanksgiving. So before the show, before we went on the music break, I was talking about some of the critical things and laying the foundation that in our world today, even though there can be a lot of ill and a lot of issues and problems, we must focus on what's working. And if we focus our strength on what's working, we will be successful. Let's not focus on what's not working. I shared about the group of people, the group which the researchers put together. Some wrote things that they were happy about, some wrote things they were angry about, and some wrote random things. You don't want to fall into the last two. You want to fall into the group of the first set of people, because they turned out to be the happiest. So before the music break, I said there's one thing I would recommend for you to start doing. And I've started doing it as well for a number of years now. And that is to have a gratitude list. It's a practical thing that you can do. It's so practical. Just every week, or if you're not chanced to do it every week, at least every month. And even if you say you can't do it every month, at the very, very, very least, once every year, write down a list of things that you're thankful of. What, the more you do it, the better you would have the spirit of gratitude. So I would recommend that you do it at least every week or every day, and at least every month at least, but not once every year. That's a bit too long. Write down things that you are thankful for. And I'm saying to the nitty-gritty, I'm thankful for the fact that I can lift my hands. I'm thankful for the fact that I can think. I'm thankful for the fact that I can even desire to get out of my problems. You know, sometimes you start to think, you know what, I need to get out of this. And then because you're thinking so much about getting out, you can start getting depressed, like, how did I come to this? And your mind goes on this roller coaster. Stop. Before your mind goes on that roller coaster, just stop. And be thankful for the fact that you can think of getting out. Because some people are in a lot of mess, but they're absolutely fine with their mess. So the fact that you're thinking of getting out is worth being thankful for. So think about that. Be thankful for the fact that you desire to be successful. Be thankful for the fact that you are listening to me, you know, because I'm thankful for the fact that you are listening to me. So it's about being thankful. And on your list, make sure you cover those seven areas which I fondly talk about. Find something to be thankful for in regards to your financial life, okay? Whether you've got a pound or you don't have a pound in your bank account, be thankful. The fact that you've got a dollar in your account, and even the fact that you have a bank account, you know, think about that. Be thankful for the fact that you have something. So you will find something, you can find something, you know. Be thankful for the last penny you spent if you don't have any penny left. So find something in your financial life that you're thankful for. Find something in your spiritual life that you're thankful for. The fact that you can pray. The fact that you can pray and believe in something. The fact that you can, you know, have, you know, your life, your salvation. You know, find something to be thankful for spiritually. Mentally, the fact that you can think. Okay, I've already mentioned that. So thankful. Be thankful for the fact that you can think. Physical. Be thankful for the fact that you can lift your hands. I already mentioned that, okay? Lifestyle. Be thankful for where you live. Be thankful for where you are, okay? Be thankful that you are still alive. That's worth being thankful for, okay? And the sixth area that I fondly talk about is family. Be thankful the fact that you were born, okay? Now, you might be an orphan. I'm sorry about that, but be thankful for the fact that you were born, because you had to be born through someone to get here. So they're still family, whether they're present or they're, you know, or they're past. You know, be thankful for your family. Be thankful for those memories that you've had growing up. And last but not the least, be thankful for your professional life. The fact that you have a job. It might not be the greatest job. It might not be the best job that you ever dreamt of. But be thankful that you have a job. Because the more you are thankful in those areas of your lives, the more life will give you. I believe categorically that to whom much is given, much is required. Even to whom little is given, even that little is still required. And the more you're diligent in the little, the more life will be favorable to you. So on today's show, we've been talking about gratitude, and I'm going to leave you with that quote, which I read not too long ago, and I thought it was critical. It says, "Live with a spirit of thanksgiving, and you will have greater happiness and satisfaction in life." Let me repeat that. Live with a spirit of thanksgiving, and you will have greater happiness and satisfaction in life. So I want to encourage you to live with the spirit of thanksgiving. Thank you so much for joining me on today's show. Thank you for always listening in. I encourage you to follow me on social media platform. It's Sheun David-Onamusi. I will be talking more about thanksgiving and gratitude. And I want to walk with you with your 2016 goals, okay? So I want us to partner. That's how I believe it. What I'm doing now is partnering with you in words. I want to keep this going. So join me, same place, same time. And remember to be inspired, to live inspired, and to stay inspired. Thank you, and have a great one.
All of your dreams, all of your ideas need one thing if you want them to come true. Inspiration. Join Sheun David-Onamusi on Inspiration Road 10 a.m. every Saturday on Radio Harold Hill. Inspiration Road, a show dedicated to keeping you company on your road to success.